Welcome to this installment of Gonzo Gamer as I head into River Crossing. This is the Union campaign. I'm Major General using the JMP mod. I put one career point into AO and the other into training. I took the 24-pound howitzers with reputation points. I ran my supply up to 25,000. I bumped my two Napoleon batteries up to 10 guns each. I gave Dunn a shell shot perk and gave him a 10th gun. I created the 24-pound howitzer battery and another ordnance rifle battery. Both have no perk. I created Porter and Franklin and gave them SP-42s. They do not have a perk. I've beefed them up because they're going to be taking the brunt of the fighting at the center where I'm going to put them. I put my carbine cav at 300 and my melee cav at 340. I pushed Price up to 450 men. In 3rd Division, I brought all of my infantry up to 1,000 men except for Scales, who has 1,070. I then created another skirmisher that does not have a perk. With training at 7, and it will go to 8 after this battle, any units that don't deploy will get 3 points into each stat this battle up to a maximum of 27. Therefore, I filled out my entire 2nd Corps as I prepare for Shiloh. All of these units are the minimum unit size and will collect XP and stats over the next 2 battles. Every stat point that they can get means I need to add fewer vets to get them to 1 star, as my goal for Shiloh is for everybody to have 1 star. You have to be very careful when employing this method of making extra units to push them to 1 star just sitting in camp, because it can affect scaling. So far in the side battles, it has had minimal scaling effects, but when I've tried to do this going into Gaines' Mill with a 3rd Corps, the AI added over 20,000 more men and 70 more guns, so I didn't use it there. I was already outnumbered 2-1, and with the extra scaling, it pushed it up to almost 3-1. Obviously, the first thing you notice at River Crossing is that we deploy in control of the Southern VP, and you only need to hold the Southern VP to get a victory, which I hear can be quite the task on Legendary difficulty. Each time that I've played River Crossing, the AI has kept its guns and some other units in order to protect the Northern VP so it doesn't bring all of them to the south. So I will be creating a perimeter to defend my VP, and depending on how aggressive the AI decides to be, I may or may not decide to push or take the Northern VP. In preparation to going to Shiloh, I'm trying to keep my officer losses down. So if I don't have to take the VP and get in the range of his guns, then I'm probably not going to do it. Enjoy the battle, and I'll comment at the end.
Thank you.
With my Kayev going up to take the supply wagon, you can see what forces the AI kept in reserve to defend the VP. I lost about 1,150 men. I lost two officers that won't be back until after Shiloh now. Trying to keep officers with Kayev is just brutal. The AI used some MJNGs, some 53 Enfields, and somebody had Harper's Ferries, which is out of the ordinary. That's it for River Crossing. I'll see you at Logan's Crossroads, which is actually super fun and challenging right now.